since these are countries where I spent a lot of time as a reporter in the 1990s, and I still feel a very close emotional connection to there. I've been dismayed by what has happened since the rebellion in Kiev that overthrew the regime of President Yanukovych. Russia has intervened in Ukraine. The result has been an enormous amount of unnecessary destruction and thousands of unnecessary deaths. It's been horrific for me to see how Russian former journalists have become propagandists serving the lies of the Putin regime about what's really going on. It's been sad to see friends of mine believing the Putin version of events put out by such organizations as the English language Russia Today news channel. But most of all, it's been so horribly sad to see all this death and destruction taking place so unnecessarily, when the things that the Russians claim to want could all have been achieved in different ways. The truth is that the extreme right in Ukraine, in the Ukrainian rebellion, which the Russians claim to be so concerned about, was never that strong in Ukrainian politics, and yet has been made much stronger by the invasion. The other goals that Putin has set himself, namely the annexation of Crimea to Russia and greater autonomy for eastern Ukraine, these are quite possibly entirely worthy goals. There are quite genuinely a lot of people in Crimea who want to be part of Russia. There are almost certainly a majority of people in the far east of Ukraine who would like a more distant relationship with Kiev. But these aims could have been achieved through politics, through patience, through protest, without the kind of bloodshed that Ukraine, left to itself, has managed to avoid for a generation. It's clear to me that the only overwhelming reason that Russian troops have forces and money have intervened in Ukraine is because Vladimir Putin fears that he will meet the same fate as the Ukrainian President Yanukovych, that he will be forced to resign and will be brought to account for the corruption of his regime. So far, he is winning. Perhaps that will not always be the case.